Mother Teresa. Time to warm up. Have you ever tried to help others? If yes, how did they react when you helped them? How did you feel on receiving praise? Time to read. Mother Teresa needs no introduction. She is an inspirational personality who poured the unconditional love for the poor. The Nobel Prize winner, acclaimed globally for her incredible and heartwarming charitable services, we can call her the kindest heart in the world. Mother Teresa's incredible services had been renowned in India as she spent several years in India. The early childhood days of this beloved personality is little known. Born in Skopje, in capital city of Republic of Macedonia. She at a very tender age had an intuition and innate feeling to serve the needy people. She had feeling that she wanted herself to be called a nun. When she turned 18 years of age, she had the permission to pursue her dream and joined a group of nuns. She had training in Ireland and after few months of training, she was permitted to visit India. Soon after arriving at India, she started working as a teacher in Calcutta. The poverty, unhealthy and deprived lifestyle all over the city created a strong impression in her mind that she should help them. This led her to begin a new order named as the Missionaries of Charity. The ultimate goal of this charity is to serve the people who had nobody to look after them. Her devotion to the charitable services had a great start in Calcutta. She devoted her entire life to help and serve the needy people. Born as a Roman Catholic, Mother Teresa always believed and preached that serving the people is the chief principle preached by Jesus Christ. Still, she had a great passion towards India and Indian customs and practices. Although she faced a few traumas due to Hindu-Muslim violence and communal violence in Calcutta, she continued her service without any hesitation. After independence, she left the convent and joined the poor in city. She began to wear white sari with blue lines in the border, respecting the Indian tradition. Her full-fledged services began and she was accompanied by many fellow nuns. The entire crew survived with little food and trivial income. She and her fellow nuns never hesitated to beg for funds as well for food sometime. Once she was invited for a grand function. On that occasion, grand feast at lunch was part of the celebration. After lunch, Mother Teresa started to collect the leftovers from the lunch plates served at the party hall. When others made fun of her, she replied them politely that there are many poor kids who have never tasted most of the food served here. Besides being a lovable and kind-hearted woman, Mother Teresa, who born as a Roman Catholic, respected the traditions of India and never went behind conversion of faith in religion. All the people in her homes and under her care were provided appropriate religious and traditional rites. The small initiation of Mother Teresa was sparked by her intuition and simple thought. Her missionaries of charity now spread across various parts of the world as a huge, strong, an undying tree with service motive to serve the homeless people. She passed away in the year 2003. Her soul remains with her. A beautiful saying by Mother Teresa. Love cannot remain by itself. It has no meaning. Love has to be put into action, and that action is her. Time to answer. Answer the following questions. First, who needs no introduction? Second, what acclaimed her globally? Third, where did she born? Fourth, when did she join the group of nuns? Fifth, what did create strong impression on Mother Teresa? Sixth, What is the ultimate goal of the charity? 7th, what did Mother Teresa always believe? 8th, how did Mother Teresa reply when people at party had made fun of her? 1st, Dash needs no introduction. 2nd, Dash is the capital city of Republic of Macedonia. 3rd, Mother Teresa started working as a teacher in Dash. 4th, Mother Teresa started the Dash. 5th, Dash can't remain itself. Clue kit: Love, Missionaries of Charities, Calcutta, Kopchi, Mother Teresa. Time to know new words. Inspirational: person or thing that motivates mentally. Unconditional: without any condition. Acclaimed: to praise enthusiastically and often publicly. Incredible: unbelievable. Charitable: generous in donations or gifts. Tender: very young. Innate: inborn. Deprived: lacking in advantage, opportunity. Ultimate: in the last or final. Devotion: a feeling of strong love or loyalty. Time to spell well. Complete the following words. Write the opposites for the following words. 1st, strong. 2nd, few. 3rd, start. 4th, arrive. 5th, new. Time to listen. Your teacher will read out the rhyming words from the lesson. Listen to them carefully. Color the bricks with the same color. Preach, teach. Tuition, intuition. Devotion, emotion. Ultimate, culminate. Tender, wonder.
Grammar, time to learn. Negative form of verb 1. Study the following sentences. Plural subject, singular subject. Girls like sweets. This boy flies kites. Girls do like sweets. This boy does fly kites. Girls do not like sweets. This boy does not fly kites. Girls don't like sweets. This boy doesn't fly kites. Do not is equal to don't. Does not is equal to doesn't. Rewrite the following sentences in 4 different ways as shown in the example above. They beat the donkey. Boys bring their books. We read this book at school. They throw stones at birds. I sleep at night. Fill in the blanks with do or does. Coffee, not grow here. This tree, not give us apples. These shops, not open on Sundays. Good boys, not laugh at others. She, not live with her mother. I, not go to cinema. Question, form of verb. Study the following sentences. Plural subject, singular subject. You get late in the morning. He gets late in the morning. You do get late in the morning. He does get late in the morning. Do you get late in the morning? Does he get late in the morning? Rewrite the following sentences in three different ways as shown in the examples above. David hits the ball. They send us gifts. We learn new words. Fill in the blanks with do or does. You go for a walk daily. Do you work on Sundays? John, come to your house. She loves her brother. Farmers grow crops. The sun shines at night. His sisters speak Bengali. Mrs. Lal teach you English.
Time to watch. Look at the picture and write what you think of it. Write your answer here. Time to speak. Practice the following sentences. Raju says it's Sunday. Rani says so. Raju says you know what that means. Rani says I forgot. Raju says Sunday means we go to church. Rani says, oh yeah. Raju says, put on a coat and tie. Rani says, why? Raju says, to show respect to God and others. Rani says, I am glad Sunday is only once a week. Raju says, I hope God did not hear that. Rani says, he'll forgive me. Time to write. Steps. Get a cardboard box, any size will do, and fit it together to look like a box. If it's not ready, cut a rectangular opening in the top, the right size to fit money in. And label if you wish. To make it easier to carry, cut another piece of cardboard out and stick it to the back of the box, sticking up so that you can lift it, or you can write donation box on it. Color the box in to make it eye-catching or paint it. If you want, put a suggested donation on the side so people know what to give.